There is no instance of police brutality where it isn't a needless tragedy, but some really stand out for just how truly horrific they are. We have a case here that happened in Pennsylvania where there was gunfire on Sunday in the parking lot of a Walmart. Okay, Rashawn Smith was hit and was apparently down, bleeding from the abdomen. Kenneth Vinyard rushed to Rashawn Smith's side while he was laying bleeding on the ground. Paramedics arrived. Vinyard had been trying to help out Rashawn during that time. Then apparently Vinyard stepped away to allow them to do their job. A man in plain clothes, who you will find out ended up being a cop, although not visibly identified as such, demanded that he get further away from the victim. He tried to explain that he was just trying to help out. So the plain clothes police officer struck him, pushed him away. He fell, hit his head on the pavement, and he died. He was a literal good Samaritan. He saw someone get shot, and rather than doing what almost every one of us would have done, which is to run away as fast as you can to protect your own life, he decided, I'm gonna go help that person, even though I could end up getting shot. I'm gonna do whatever I can to help this person. The authorities, the ones who are supposed to be able to count on, show up, assault the good Samaritan and take his life. Just completely senseless. This is a person who was doing what every one of us would love to dream that we would do and lost their life as a result of it. I can't imagine a worse tragedy than this, JR.
Well, as you said, many of us would dream to be the person who has the courage and the ability to try and save someone's life in a traumatic, dramatic situation like this. But everyone's not like that. You said all of us would want to dream to. Some people dream of watching people die in the streets. Some people look at folks that are on the ground bleeding from like something like a gunshot wound and go, F that guy. And anybody who helps them, I don't want them helping him either, because I'd rather see this happen. There are humans out there in our country, apparently this guy is one of them, who would take some joy in seeing that happen. So much so that his aggression and his anger overtake him to stop anyone from ending his fantasy of watching something in real life happen that he would just love to see. He's like, no, 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 this is what I've been waiting for however old this idiot is. 39 years, I'm seeing it now. No, no, get away. Yeah. Now he's part of this entire situation. Instead of sitting back and hoping, maybe praying that the guy would die in the parking lot while someone's trying to save his life, instead he made sure of it. God, I can't stand these people.
I can't, like, again, he could have rightly been worried that he was in danger immediately after the shooting. But it turned out that the greatest danger to his life came when the cop showed up, as is so often the case. How devastating. And then on top of all this, an added layer of just, I cannot imagine. So state police have confirmed that they're investigating Vinyard's death. They say that they plan to talk to the Center Township officer, the guy who killed him, as early as Wednesday. This news originally broke like 2 days ago. The shooting was several days ago. What do you mean you're gonna talk to him as soon as Wednesday? You know, well, probably Wednesday we'll do it. Call him. Call him right now. Like, he's literally there. Like, do you not have his number? Do you not know where those cops generally congregate? Like, do they have a building, like an office? What do you mean by Wednesday we'll get around to it? He took a guy's life. Based on all of the evidence that we have, he resulted in the guy's death, and you're eventually gonna get around to talking to him? Are you not merciful?
Hi there.
Hey.
What's this in your back pocket? I just saw you walking it.
The navigational aids. What's the problem? You a tyrant?
Yeah, I am actually. What's your name and date of birth?
I don't have to give that unless
yes, sir. I was investigating.
You have reasonable.
Do you want me to put you in handcuffs right now? Yes, sir, I do.
What is your suspicion?
It looks like you're carrying a gun in your back pocket. I'm stopping to make sure you're carrying it properly.
You well, don't have you to... ensured that it's not a firearm?
No, you keep turning so I can't see it. You don't have to be a d- to me.
So you might be familiar with this story at this point. This is a legally blind man in Florida, James Hodges, being approached because of his cane. They think it's some sort of weapon, and so the cops decide to hassle him. We have some updates on this story, but just in case you're not familiar with the entire interaction, let's jump into a little bit more of the video.
Push the stop before. Or a walking stick.
So, and it could look like a weapon. She asked you to
really
present it, okay?
Now she's asking me for ID.
Okay. I don't need the ID unless there's reasonable, articulated suspicion and her that I have committed a crime, am committing a crime, and or about to do a crime.
Sir, and her suspicion was that you were armed, okay, and she's asking you for your ID.
Well, now she has verified that I am not armed, okay. So there is no problem.
You have your ID or not?
I do have my ID, okay. But you don't need it,
okay? Okay.
Mr. Hodges, was that hard?
It's gonna be. I want your name and your badge number.
You know, I'm putting him in jail for resisting.
Okay.
So, is that so hard? And James Hodges says, it's gonna be. Well, he knew what was going on. He knew the actual regulations, and he also knew how this is probably likely to go down. Those deputies are now facing suspension without pay. One of them, Harrison, was demoted after the investigation. So there have been some consequences, perhaps not as much as we would want, of course. I personally think that those videos demonstrate everything that is wrong with the psychology of far too many cops. Whether you think that she was justified in stopping him in the first place, and I think most people probably would not, once he demonstrated that he was just a legally blind man with a cane, that should be it. Or maybe not it. Maybe there should be an apology and then that's it. You move on with your life. But unfortunately, these cops felt like he had been challenged them. So now, even though they've got nothing, they know that they've got nothing, they have to hassle this guy, joking about being tyrants, insisting that they see his ID. They don't need his ID for literally anything. He doesn't have a gun. They know that they're just hassling a guy because of his walking stick, Adrienne. And as a result of their need to prove that they're powerful and strong and alpha, how dare you question us? They're suffering the consequences now.
Yeah, and they should indeed suffer consequences. It's like these officers, oftentimes they think everything is a gun. Everything is a gun, but when there's an actual gun, oh no, it can't be found. It's so incredibly mesmerizing, this thought that this walking stick that this man has, he is legally blind, that the officer would use that as a pretext to hassle him. Because it does not make any logical or reasonable sense. But what it does communicate to me is that this is a power trip in action and an abuse of power. And the thing is that it's instances like this that deteriorate the relationship between the community and law enforcement. Because why wouldn't it? It's absolutely absurd.